Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about parametric equations. Parametric equations are important because they give more information than what you would get from a regular equation that just uses xy coordinates. Normally with an equation using xy coordinates, we're able to tell the vertical and horizontal displacement of an object, but we don't know the time at which the object are in those positions or locations. Using a parametric equation, we add a parameter t, and with that parameter t, we can say that at this particular time, the object has moved so many units vertically and so many units horizontally. So let's go ahead and take a look at the simple example here. First, we're going to look at two parametric equations that we can graph, and then we're going to take those parametric equations and change them into their rectangular equation. All right, so let's begin. Start off with x is equal to t plus 2. In this equation, t is the parameter, and y is equal to 2t, and again, t is the parameter. We're going to put some limits on the value of t. So we're going to say t can be as small as negative 3 and as large as positive 3. So with this information, we're going to create a table where we're going to list all the values of t. Negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Again, going from smallest to largest. And then we're going to also find the values of x and the values of y. Simply stated, all you have to do is substitute in the values of t into each equation. So let's begin with x. If I substitute in a negative 3, I'm going to end up with the expression negative 3 plus 2. And that resolves to negative 1. And then if I do the next value of t for just the x, negative 2 plus t, that gives me a 0. Negative 1 plus 2 gives me a positive 1. 0 plus 2 gives me 2. And if I continue down, you see that my answers are going to be 3, 4, and 5 when I make those substitutions. Now let's focus on y. In the equation for y, we're multiplying 2 times whatever the value of t is. In this case, starting all over, 2 times negative 3 gives me negative 6. 2 times negative 2 gives me a negative 4. 2 times a negative 1 gives me a negative 2. 2 times 0 gives me 0. 2 times 1 gives me 2. And then we see the last values are going to be 4 and 6 as they continue, as it continues the pattern. All right, so we see that at time negative 3, the coordinates are going to be negative 1, negative 6. At time negative 2, the coordinates are 0, negative 4. And as I continue, 1, 2, 2, 0, 3, 2. 4, 4, and 5, 6. At this point, I could draw a xy coordinate here, coordinate plane, and then I could plot each one of these points. We're going to skip ahead a little bit and pick some of the easier points, like here, 0, negative 4. So let's say I'm at 0. Let's say this point down here is negative 4. And then let's pick this coordinate here, 2, 0. Let's say this here is 2 units over. And I didn't move up or down, so I'm right there on the axis. And what I would do is then draw a line to connect these points. And again, it's bounded from negative 3 to positive 3 because those are my t values. As t increases, I see that this graph is moving in this direction. So that's what the arrows signify if I were to write the graph or draw the graph by hand as such. Now let's take a look at a calculator so that we can actually put these values in and ensure that our hand calculations are correct. All right, here I have the Texas Instruments 84 Plus Silver Edition. Let's go ahead and turn the calculator on. And then let's make sure that we're in the proper mode. For these calculations, we need to be in parametric mode, which we see here. And that's the only thing that we need to worry about for this particular set of equations that we're using. So from here, let's go to our graphing mode, and we're going to put in the two graphs. We're going to put in the two equations, The first equation for x, we said that that was t plus 2. And then we said the parametric equation for y was 2 times t. So there are my two equations. And now I want to go ahead and graph that. When I graph, you see I do have a linear equation, basically a straight line. And what I want to do now is trace. So we click the trace button. The trace button is going to allow us to validate the numbers that we came up with by hand, our calculations here. So it begins with t being at negative 3. Again, I've already set this up, but what you would do is click on your window button. And on your window button, you see I set the minimum value for t to be negative 3. The maximum value for t to be positive 3. And I set t to move in increments of 1. So let's go ahead and go back to the graph and then click on trace again. So we see here that when t is at negative 3, we see we are correct that it's at position negative 1, negative 6 for xy coordinates. Now I'm going to increment t to negative 2. And we see that, again, our calculation is correct at position 0, 4. At time negative 1, we're at position 1, negative 2. At time 0, here you see we are correct again at position 2, 0. When t equals 1, we're at 3, 2. When t is at 2, we're at position 4, 4. And when t is at position 3, we're at coordinate 5, 6. So that mirrors exactly what our hand calculations were. So that wraps up everything for part A. Let's put the calculator away for now, and let's go ahead and move on to part B. In part B, we need to convert this parametric equation into a rectangular equation. Basically stated, that means eliminate the t parameter and keep everything in terms of x and y. So let's begin by rewriting the first equation. X is equal to t plus 2. To isolate the t, let's subtract 2 from both sides. When we subtract 2, that eliminates the 2 on the right-hand side. We're left with t is equal to x minus 2. So now we have everything in terms of t. So I'm going to take this value of t and substitute that back into the second equation. Second equation was y is equal to 2t. So now instead of writing t, I'm going to write x minus 2. And then I'm going to distribute that 2 to both terms. So 2x minus 4. So I have y is equal to 2x minus 4, and that there is our rectangular equation. If we take a moment, we notice that this equation is in slope-intercept form, where we see the slope is positive 2, and we see that the y-intercept is at negative 4. And if we look at our calculations, we see that we do have our y-intercept here of negative 4. And by the hand drawing, we see we do have a positive slope. Again, one more indication that our calculations are correct. All right, so that sums it up for this video on parametric equations from Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name, Speller Tutorial. Have a great day, and thank you again for watching.